Hello, welcome to the Cozy Corner, and welcome to another Power Fantasy. Today, we're playing Final Fantasy III. Now, since we're playing a PC game on Steam as opposed to emulator, we're not going to be using classic stuff like action replays. Instead, we're going to be using something more modern. We're going to be using a cheat engine, table. I'm not going to be doing it just on the fly. I've got a table here with some nice things to do. So, here we begin. I didn't see that hole there. What have I gotten myself into now? If you've ever heard of Final Fantasy III before, you know it didn't originally come out in the US. It was an NES game, like 1 and 2. And the first time the US got it was actually a remake of it for the DS, which I got that when it first came out. One thing they changed is instead of just having unnamed generic characters, they gave them each names and personalities. So here's our main character, Lunith. I mean, technically all four characters are about as important, but Lunith is the leader. They each have their own little story arcs in some of the parts, and that's kind of nice. It makes the game a little bit better, I think. I'm not a fan of just the empty characters. Final Fantasy 1 did it first, so it's fine. So, first we're gonna get this first battle out of the way. And then we're gonna open up our cheat table here and see what we can mess around with. Now, one thing I was thinking about is that Final Fantasy 2 just wasn't as fun to watch as the first one, I don't think. And that's because of the leveling system fucking everything up and me just maxing stats out, turning off battles. I'm gonna go back to what we were doing in 1 where we just had quicker level ups. And I'm also not gonna give us all the jobs at once in this game. I'm going to let us get the jobs naturally, and we'll shift and change our playstyle a little bit for each one. But we are going to make ourselves extremely overpowered. This is not the safest place to be. Okay. Good stuff. Oh, by the way, if you're ever playing this on Steam, you absolutely, before you start the game, go to the button configurations. They are fucked on controller. Because they have cancel and confirm backwards. And it fucking sucks. Also, there's a pause that's not the menu that you want to hit the pause button on the 360 controller. Switch those around. I had to stop recording and start over because I was screwing around so much just trying to get the controls to work. But this way, it's fine. Alright, so. Hold on one second here. I'll pause the game. Let's look at our scripts. Let's look at our pointers. What we got? Jobs level up with one action. That seems pretty good. We'll turn that on. Job level and character level are a little bit different. Infinite arrows would be useful when we have arrows. No? Cheat engine is acting extremely funny right now. Okay, well, we won't use those fucking codes then. Some of them are just not turning on. Pointers. This lets us change stuff, right? Characters. Yeah, here we go. Character slot 1. Hands level. What's that mean? Oh. We're not looking for this. We're not looking for you. Oh, it's a money modifier. Let's modify our money. I don't know how much you can have in this game, but let's go. That should be a decent amount of money. There we go. The game's pausing when I'm going off to this cheat table to the side here. Items. Inventory. Do we have a drop-down? If we don't have a drop-down, that's really lame. Um, Let's just say we get an item. Oh, we don't even have any items. We might need to get an item to start. Or unless we're looking at a knife. Okay, well. Item ID. I was hoping for, you know, just give me all the items kind of thing. But that's not what we got. A little less fun. Let's see. Infinite items could be useful. Alright, we're going to be a little slow to start here. I think we need to get a couple items to get things going. So, well, bear with me for just a second. We got to get out of this starting situation. Okay. Let's see. Two chests, here we go. A potion. A leather shield. You know, what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to wait till we have our whole team together. Then I'll say, pause, cut the video, and then cut back when I change their equipment. I think that'll be a good way to do this. The games are not going to be as short as the other two because they're becoming fleshed out now at this point. Especially 4 is going to be longer. Z to take a closer look? It's not. Let's do this. Oh no, you didn't. Another thing is, so your stats will just be different based on your level and what job you have. They're static that way. Except for your HP. Your HP is based on whatever your vitality is when you're leveling up. So, I'm not going to do the quick level up until we've actually gotten other classes, because the Freelancer doesn't give you good boosts, and I don't want to gimp our characters. That's the opposite of what we want to do. We gotta be smart about our cheating. A long sword. That's better than a knife. The cheapy look works really well, I gotta say, especially higher res like this. Magic Wind, that's an item that does damage. Those are really useful, especially when we unlock a certain job. Carbuncle. Not the carbuncle I'm thinking of. I guess a carbuncle is a kind of boil, isn't it? Not a cute little furry finnick fox thing. It's green and has a little ruby in its head. Potion. What are you? Don't you critical me for one, you piece of shit? This is not working out so well. That thing is pretty physical resistant, I'd guess. There we go. Even though it's 30, it does feel like it's flowing pretty decent. I mean, it's obviously a little shaky and stuff. You really do wish they could have just, you know, it was they put it on iOS and DS and PSP. You think they could have done something? First. will do a little bit more damage to this blue wisp. Well, we have infinite items, don't we? So that means this shouldn't get used up when we use it. Make sure that's infinite items is really... Yep, it is. Cool. We don't have all these weird item glitches like in the second game, too. That's one nice thing. Alright. A wellspring. What mystifying colors. HP, MP restored. This game makes me feel a little bit nostalgic. When did the DS version come out? I mean, it was on the DS. DS was what, 2004? Or was it 2006? Was it 2006? It preceded the Wii. The Wii was 2006, so 2004. This probably came out in what, 2005? Maybe 2006. I don't remember. What's that? Evil creature attacks Luna. Our first boss battle, Lanturtle. But you know he's a reptile, so... should be weak to ice. Or not. Well, let's see how much that damage compares to my attack. Okay, it's better to use Antarctic Winds. I think one more will do it. We should have 120 HP. For some reason, intro cinematic wasn't running well, else I would have played that at the beginning. It's easy to look up. But I was thinking of starting out the game with the characters and the roles that are in that intro cinematic, so we'll have a warrior, red mage, white mage, black mage. Who's that? Who's there? There are others who share your destiny. You must seek them out. Now go. Man, it just makes me think, like, if only they had given this treatment to 5 and 6 instead of those mobile ports. Like, the art design for those mobile ports is the reason I don't have them on Steam. I refuse to buy, like, such butchered versions of the game. If they had at least, like, stuck, like, the GBA versions as a, like, a, with them or something like that, I would have bought it. Makes me so mad. Especially 6. I don't really, you know, I'll be honest, I never finished 5. This will be my opportunity to do so, even though it's not, like, a legitimate way of doing it. But still. Okay. I love it. Just like... it's kind of cool because I'm thinking about, like, as an animator, like, they're just using, like, a little, you know, a little plane there in the background with a rotating spear behind it, and it still looks good, you know? You can make a low-poly game that looks really good. I'm surprised more people don't try to do this. Lunith, the elders are looking for you. King Sasune's castle is to the west of here. He is the lord of all the land surrounded by the Parmeni Mountains, including this village. Well, that's no good. Not Kazus. Man, 3 added a lot of features, now that I think about it. Like, it's a big game for the series, even if we didn't get it in the US. Chosen for what? I don't understand. Sure thing. Kazus. Also, having all 4 of my shoulder buttons is, funny. Just like, the change. Ooh, what you got, buddy? Now, I'm buying these to give me item slots, if you understand what I'm saying. If I give myself item slots, I can switch items out in the inventory screen. Since we're not giving ourselves all the items, since that's not really a thing in the cheat table, you can just use the numbers to change things around. We're giving ourselves the best gear, but we need some item slots in order to do that. I didn't believe in spooks until I saw one at Kazus. Is that what it said? Now, I don't think there's a item limit in this one either, so that helps us out. Also, you're still buying spells in this one. Still on that idea. It's just you can only use them in certain magic in certain classes. Okay. Let's see. Now, if I'm thinking right, I should still have these items, because they're infinite. And I'm not. I have to have more than one. Okay. Fair enough. Can't cheat as hard in this one. Don't worry, we will. We'll get to it. It'll feel overwhelming soon. Except for the stat maxes. The stat maxes do kind of hold us back a bit. we can turn off encounters. And a nice thing is it gives us a button to instantly fight if we want to, so we can just, like, spam fights really quick. I might do that and then, like, actually edit, like, speed up the video. So you can see that I did it. But we don't. I'll think about it. Go to Ur. Oh my. That is quite the curse. Yeah, it's a ghost. Am I too scared to get? Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to enter them. Stupid werewolf. Well, you're a jerk. Does this hit all enemies? Let's find out. Nope. Am I just forgetting the order you're supposed to do things in this game? This guide's terrible at telling you that. Where am I supposed to go then? Can't go to Kazoos. Can't. I felt like there was supposed to be a seam of arc already, but we didn't get it. Battles are a little slow, aren't they? You know what, this guide is talking about both the NES and the DS version at the same time? No wonder it's confusing the shit out of me. Yeah, I was right, you do find Ark first. Alright, I'm not crazy. Oh, So there's some items. I see. Okay, pick up some items. Here, eye drops, longsword, dagger, phoenix down. I don't know why there's goblins in the village. Okay. Can we stop this, please? Ludif doesn't understand why he's going to be a level 50 freelancer before he finds his friend. I don't either. So can we stop it? Oh yeah, ghosts don't exist, then go there yourself and prove it. Another orphan raised by Topapa and Lunav's best friend. Unlike Lunav, he prefers reading over gamboling in the wild. His studies endow him with great knowledge that more than makes up for his shyness. Bark! Resident fuckboy. Now, damn it, Ark. Oh, hold on a second. Let's heal. This is quicker. Now, I just remembered there might be more items in the altar cave. Let's save really quick. Level 15 at the job already. Yeah, I think there might be some more items here. Leather cap. Bronze bracers. Sounds good. Wait, I already got bronze bracers, don't I? What I'm wanting, I think there's a spell in here. Oh, back attack. They'll put me in the back row. I think it might. I think it reverses your formation. So they're not even gonna be able to damage me. Thank you. Alright, we've actually leveled up that time, didn't we? Longsword. Bronze bra- second bronze bracers. There we go, sleep. Alright, let's take a look at our item list here. Yeah, okay, we got some magic now. Is there better equipment? I think we got. Should have bought two of each of them. That way we never run out. And then, ooh, almost fell. Bronze knuckles. Well, that's right, if you, I could. And then, get out. Maybe we did before. No encounters? That was nice. We have to be a freelancer for the first mission, so I'm not running away just so I can swing and kill quick with Lunif. Because going up your job level, that increases your the number of hits you can do and stuff like that. Also, your hands, like the hand you're swinging with has proficiency, so you can increase your ability to swing weapons with that hand by using it more. Alright. Now we're back. Okay. Now we're gonna meet Ark. Also, in this game, Phoenix Downs are very rare. They're actually very useful. So you want to be careful of them. Hey, Ark. You want. Arcs joined the party. Does that staff? I don't think you can cast anything with it. Do anything while they're all like this. Oh, dang. Oh, man, fucking genies. That's what this is about, huh? Daughter run off, that's not a very good thing to do. Now is it? What do we got here? There's some hidden treasure somewhere here. This didn't help. I know there's treasure here. I swear to Zeus, I'm gonna find the treasure. Unless I'm crazy and there really isn't treasure. I swore there was, though. Okay, I'm crazy. Never mind. It's a combination of me having a guide here, the general locations, and memory from playing the game. I got much better memory with 4 and 7. They're supposed to be. God damn it. Now, I am absolutely positive I'm supposed to go west and find an airship. Unless there's something farther west that I'm missing. There isn't. I'm absolutely right. You're supposed to get Rukia in that. I'm getting incensed, people. I know you're supposed to go here, so why doesn't it trigger anything? I'm gonna talk to the smith one more time. Sid first? Is that what it is? That's right. One of these guys is Sid. Ain't that a trip and a half? Okay, yeah, now we can do it. What's this guy do? Okay, now we should definitely find her. Aha. Who are you? What are you doing here? I can ask you the same thing. This is Sid's airship, and he's letting us use it. Raised in Kazus by the Mithril Smith, Taka, whose rigorous training led her to run away from home. Again. Rukia. I actually really like the cast in this game. I didn't study that far, I didn't want to swell. There we go. Let me check something really quick. Dear Lord, it's taken just as long to unlock the first jobs as we could have gone through several quests in the old games. Well, that's the limitations of modern games and cheating. They just don't like it when you do it compared to old ones. Old ones... You remember Final Fantasy 2? They had a weapon that's laughing about you making... about you cheating. Oh, I think it's the... Rifia, what do you got, girl? Put you in the back. Alrighty, won't hurt, right? All aboard! Yes! By the first... Before we even assemble the party, we already have an airship. Isn't that swell? I'm the daughter of the blacksmith of Gazoos. The king must still have the ring my father made him. Yes, I believe I can arrange that. Come, I'll be waiting in the throne room. This is a pretty nice king. You know, just some kids can come up and meet him. Genie myself. Genie is the same thing. It's the same thing. We just call it different. We just call them different things. Is there something? Phoenix down. That's always good. Let's go and get our boy first. King looks the same as anybody else when he's just a outline. A loyal soldier of King Sassoon's army, he narrowly escaped the djinn's curse. His prime concern is finding the missing Princess Sarah. Old Ignis. Of course not, his sword has worked twice out of these two. Okay. Let's see. You can use two long swords, Jimmy. Because you fuck like a champ. We'll take. She's in the back row. She doesn't need the bracers. Well, Okay. Okay, so if we go back to where we were, go through the right wall here. Upstairs. Find two treasure chests. Leather shield. Lizard. Hold on 1 second! Items. Highlighted item. Oh, there is a drop-down menu. Cool. There we go. Let's start teaching some magic. Cure. Refia. Poisona. Lizard. Sleep. Blizzard. Okay. So we'll move. Let's see. Formation. That might increase intelligence. Yeah, here we go. Now we have a little differentiation between our stuff. Okay, there's something I do want to look up. So every class, when you reach max level of the job, has a master gear. So, if we, for instance, go over to, let's say we go to equipment, we'll remove these bronze bracers here. Go over to them. Okay. And then we go to our little cheat engine here. Yeah. And then we can change those to... Is that the right item? It is. Only 5 of those, please. Now, we should have celestial gloves. And those give you 15 to every stat. A nice change, right? He's a level higher. Good stuff. That should make a difference, I would think. Okay, so let's see. another hidden wall we can walk through. Another bronze knuckles. Oh, I want to make sure that Infinite Arrows is on too. That doesn't seem to work. Oh well. We have infinite items. That should probably do the same thing, I would think. Holy arrow! What an arrow. You can sort of see how we're going to be setting up the team, right? Enemies. We only got three charges, so. Gee, Jimmy, why do you got two swords? Oh, yeah. Now we're getting strong. Doesn't seem to be working anymore. Did I turn it off on accident? It's not like I can't just get myself more arrows when I need them. There we go. We have a little sub-boss here. Old Griffin. I don't think he's gonna last very long. Took two hits, though. Right Slayer. As you can see, your intelligence stat actually affects how strong you are at using items. What do you know? The perfect thing to hit with a Right Slayer. Look at that sword, it looks cool, doesn't it? Wow, staff doesn't do any damage, even with those boosted stats in the back row. But yeah, obviously the Right Slayer is good slaying undead. The characters are getting levels, which you don't really want while we're freelancers. But it was worth it for the equipment. I guess. I guess I'm going to change the equipment anyway as soon as I unlock the classes, but whatever. So we're going to go fight some Jin. Oh no, floating coins! I think I'm gonna make Ark just swing his staff just to get some, swinging EXP. Like, get his arm strength up. That's kind of a cool feature, that you have a hidden, level for your arms. How strong they've gotten at swinging weapons. Independent of all your character level and your class level, that's a cool little feature. And it's kind of hidden. But it makes a big difference near the end of the game. That's why I'm going ahead and doing two swords on one character to get it, because I'm planning on making him a dual wielder in the future. You can play a little bit more flavorfully in this game. Not the mummy. Holy arrows are really useful right here, at this point in the game. The undead do not like them. The Ranger's a really good class. It's like the second tier class you can get. Because of the ability to switch items, you can switch your arrow types on the fly. So if they have elemental weakness, you can exploit them. Otherwise, you can go for status effects and stuff like that. It's Princess Sarah. Ignis, thank the heavens you're all right. So you get guest characters in this game too. And basically, they're not actually part of the team. Like, stat-wise, you don't see their HP MP. Well, they'll just jump in every once in a while and unleash attacks. And they're actually pretty useful. Princess Sarah has joined the party. The djinn is a fire elemental. It should be susceptible to cold. Isn't that nice? What button does it want me to press to talk to her? I pressed C on the keyboard because it said that. I'm just curious what actual button it wants. Oh, square, X, whatever you want to call it. I think they have different things to say in different rooms. Right? Nope, guess not. I'm a silly. Maybe in different cities and stuff. Whoa, those are some tall skeletons. Look how tall them guys are. Not gonna stand much of a chance against two holy weapons. I am here too. Well, she uses Kira, but I think she can also cast a wind spell. I love your character just starts comboing the shit out of stuff. Arctic wind. Did we come from that room? I think we might have. I've got you covered. There we go. It's just pretty good damage for that point of the game, you know. I'm silly. Alright. Up here. They're taking a knee. Can't just save anywhere in this one. Time for the djinn. In pre-Islamic Arab culture, the djinns were elemental spirits associated with air and wind, while the fire elemental spirits, like this djinn boss, were the ifrits. The two other elementals were marids for water and ghouls for darkness. Well, I don't know if that's supposed to be a bestiary entry or what. Look at this fucking djinn. Ha 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 ha! Your bauble has no power over me now, infused with the power of darkness. Oh shit! Sarah's in here. Well, you know what? We didn't heal before the fight, so that's kind of nice. Get him! Oh, not bad. That'll do. Fucking dead. We're in a ring or something. Uh-oh, where are we going? Oh, she was worried about Agnes. Agnes, you gotta keep on that. She's a princess. Thank you. It's the cave with the crystal. It is I who summoned you. You four have been chosen to be the warriors of light, the bringers of hope. You must take with you the last of my light and the last of our world's hope. As is typical in Final Fantasy games, we get our introductory music after our first quest. I hope you figured this out by now. When the four were bathed in its light, they knew its will, its fear, its hope, and the destiny that awaited them. You must drive the darkness from this world and restore light to its rightful place. You are our last hope. Huh?